So for everyone who has pretty much have visited the webcam.my website, you would or probably just through iTunes, you will notice that we do have all our recordings up. So it's like every single month, except for February 2001, we have an audio recording for every single event. So woo! How it came about and my own workflow when it comes to from raw audio to the podcast and onto iTunes, and hopefully you get 5-star rankings all over the place. So I will try to go through the process. So how it got started, I have a confession. I'm pretty much a entrepreneur, meaning that I pretty much feed on anything about startup entrepreneurship. I just read anything. So in January 2001, there's when I see, Chris Ong. he is a very successful entrepreneur. He's like, God, I have to record this. I really have to record this because you have to sort this. It's like you learn a lot of things when you sort just listen through the audio again and again. So, as I just upload it up and upload audio, suddenly just came to me. It's like, all of these audio files, it just serves as a good thing to share. It's like, you can't care for a webcam. It's like you can just download this audio from somewhere. So it's like it's kind of like a very small idea virus that you can sort of just spread it out. And eventually, it does help to sort of gain more audience around this event. So it's like, and it's definitely something that will really work in promoting your stuff. So it's like. And one of the most shared items is actually holding hands. It's a poem recital back in June 2001. Woo! It's not even tech related. It's like, honestly, it's just one of those heartfelt moments you couldn't. It's like, if you didn't come for the event, you'll miss it. But now, since we do have a recording, we can just spread it out. So, check it out. Definitely. So, how would you start in creating podcasts? It's like, first thing first, you just need to record it. Now actually we do have a record, Joshua did help us to record it out over here. You can use your iPhone, you can use your Android phone, whatever. So long it can record audio, that would do good. Generally I just prefer that you use a dedicated IC recorder, because not that your iPhone or Android wouldn't work well, just that IC recorders typically they are much more simpler to use, and they have auto-leveling features and stuff, which makes it easier, because the default voice recording app in iPhone is it won't level the audio and stuff, so it's like you do need to do some extra editing work. Or otherwise, get a third-party condenser mic for your iPhone and download a third-party app for it that records in higher quality audio, so just keep in mind when it comes to recording. And as you are in the event, just make sure that you always keep notes, because you just need to know, especially if you are creating a podcast, talks like this, there are various segments and you need to know what kind of contents and stuff. You just have to jot down all the notes. It's like, okay, what this speaker speaks and everything, what time was it. So I'll go deep why note-taking is very important at this stage, because you wouldn't want to go through 2 hours of audio just to retake all the notes again. It's like, I gone through that. It's like, yeah. It's dreadful. So you can see from my notes over here. This is back in June 2001. As you can see, it's like what is being shared and stuff. So after you've got the raw audio, you just take it home. If you don't edit it, it's not going to do anything anyway. So it's like you have to edit it, make it sound better, so that it's at least something that you can. People when they listen to it, amateur stuff, I just stop it. So you just need to do at least sprinkle some salt and pepper, just make it nice, make it sound nice and everything. So the whole thing is it depends on what kind of atmosphere you want to create. In this case, it's like I want my audio to feel like you are live at the event. You want to see how the people, you want to see all the audio, you want to hear the audience reaction, you want to feel the excitement. So it's like so the tools that I use to sort of just recreate the whole soundscape is pretty much I mainly use Audacity as a free open source audio editing tool. And together with GarageBand or Drax. Usually I don't use GarageBand and Drax that much, but it's like in order for me to create the audio chapters, it's like I have one big audio file, but I want to sort of like have an audiobook quality that okay, I can skip to that section, skip to specific sections, I can do it. So it's like I need GarageBand and Drax to do so for me. So this is the time, basically this is why you should make notes, and because the second time around you just want to sort of just skim through very fast. And you sort of like you have to keep track of the timestamps, who was sitting there, what was happening, and yes, stuff that I want to censor as well. Check out the August issue if you miss what's happening over there. Okay, in case you sort of like recorded using your iPhone and your audio just sounds like loud at some parts, then it's like weak at some parts, it's like you can use this free tool called Levelator. It sort of like levels your audio to a very clean file where it's like everything is consistent, you don't hear like suddenly like very soft, like boom! A loud sound suddenly just there. So it's like you just need to make sure. So this Levelator will sort of like just iron everything out so that everything is equal, so that it just feels more pleasant if it's everything is consistent. So after that, it's like one of the most common thing is that when you listen to your recording, sometimes you will hear like hums, hisses, sometimes like some noise behind it. So you sort of like you have to tune the equalizer, sort of like to kill off the noise. What I usually do is just zero out all the low frequencies so that the hums weren't there, but it will still feel natural. What my experimentation just shows that usually if you saw like zero, about like 125 kilohertz, that would be fine usually. So and second thing is that, and during these kind of events, they usually have some like very like silence or probably like stuff that you don't want in, or pretty much distractions. It's like sometimes it's like when Wuhan wants to set up the whole, it's like there will be like 10-second silence when Wuhan is setting up the slides and everything, or if somebody just drops a cup or spills all over the place, you just want to snip it off. So it's like those, like you need to cut this off. You just need to make sure that you don't, it's like everything is like just sounds more professional, a bit like it just flows in a way. And one shortcut that I really use usually, if you want to, it's like one of the quick audio, it's like one of the shortcuts is that because it's like you don't want to sort of like just go through the whole 2 hour video audio again, usually you'll try to, what I usually do is I'll just try to spot certain patterns, signatures, sound signatures. So every single person have their own unique sound bite, I would say, sound signature. So it's like you see Harrington has the more like then it's like Chen Shui has a more like there's a thicker like it's like baritone range over there. You can see the light blue region over there. And Wuhan typically is more like there's a major wave. Then it's like the cheerful applause will typically like very loud, very like very frequent. You can see the spot, it's like pretty much as all the clapping going on. So you just have to sort of like just spot these kind of signatures so that when you saw like so that you can identify which segments very fast. I wish I can have a demo, but five speakers. So and after that it's like as you sort of like just edit things out, you sort of like you want to add some effects and stuff. So it's like you try to, at the beginning, you try to have a fade-in effect so that it's like from very soft to loud. Then it's, you eventually you sort of like you need to sort of squish some parts. It's like sometimes it's like the transitions doesn't feel right because of the cutting. It's like sometimes it's like it just like the volumes just doesn't feel right. Sometimes you just have to just shake the curves a bit. So after you shape the curves and just one, it's like as you edit, just make sure always keep your raw files and edit files separately. Don't overwrite. Really, don't overwrite. It's like always keep your raw files in the same place so that if you want to re-edit it again, you can re-edit it again and again and again. Don't have to worry. I did this mistake actually. It's like I pretty much lost the raw file for January, March, and April. So if I want to re-edit a higher quality version of it, I couldn't. So just make sure, don't overwrite your files, never. Never, never, like a source code, never, never. And now you have a shiny new audio file, so it's like, okay, I want this up on iTunes so that people can subscribe to it. So this is the part that gets interesting. For events like this, I typically prefer one large file with audio segments. So the way to do it is that use GarageBand, use the chapter feature, so you have chapter markers over here. You can just look up on one of those tutorials online. Usually I have one big file, it's like for the whole event and pretty much a segmented event. So it's like actually there's two, if you notice webcam of mine, there's actually two feeds. One is the whole event recording and the second one is individual talks. So once you have the file, the second thing is that you want it in your WordPress blog. So that it's like, the plugins that I use is one is called a Blueberry PowerPress, and the second one is Advanced Category Extruder. The first one is so that you can have like album arts, your podcast title, your descriptions. Then it's like for every episode, there's summary. You can use your blog post as the summary for that episode. So it's like Blueberry does a great job for that. So use that. And I will tell you why you need the second one, the Advanced Category Extruder. Okay, why you need it is because it's like, especially for a webcam, if you see the main page, it's like I typically just post, and make sure that only the full audio recording goes on the home page. But I don't want the individual talks to be there because it's like typically there'll be like four or five files, then it will sort of pollute the home page. So it's like I'll use the Category Extruder to exclude the individual talks and probably some photos sometimes, so that's why I use it. One mention is that another very good podcast from Patrick, it's called Project Concrete Jungle. When they upload their files, it's like you can upload to your server, but you need to make sure that you use streaming. So it's like one of the cheats that they use, I find it very very interesting, is that they use Dropbox as they are very cheap CDN in a way. And the good part is that Dropbox automatic helps you, it does audio streaming as well. So actually that's one cool trick that I learned from them. No time to do it for my camp of mine, probably sometime.
Is it good streaming or you can jump ahead?
Yeah, you can do so. So that's
the server as Dropbox itself.
So yeah, eventually I suppose. Then after that it's like Then your notes come very handy when it comes to writing blog posts. It's like you need a summary for people to know, okay, what this audio is about, why should I listen to it? Because it's like, even 20 minutes audio is like, that's 20 minutes of my time. It's like I don't have time to listen to something crappy. So it's like you just sort of like have to write the summary and stuff so to entice people to listen to it. So that's why you should keep notes. And after that, and Blueberry PowerPress will have one section over here so that you can say where the file is uploaded, then as well that you can specify the file size, duration and stuff, and yeah, the explicit tag, so I have to edit out the button to avoid the explicit tag, so sorry, I have to censor that one. Then after you say like, I have the WordPress blog, okay, now I've uploaded my files, now I have my blog post as well, so the next logical thing to do is to test it on iTunes. You just go to iTunes. There's one drop down, I can't remember which one, I think it's podcast, press subscribe to podcast, then you just fill it in, press OK, make sure that it pops up and it will download the file properly. Once that's done, the next logical step will be submit to iTunes, just go to podcast, submit the podcast over there. Once done, you just pray that people will go and just subscribe to it, listen to it, spread the word out, and hopefully get some 5 stars so that you can get featured on iTunes. So please do so. 5 stars, please. Okay. So two podcasts that I feature here is one is our own. The second one is Project Concrete Jungle, where Patrick interviews local entrepreneurs. How they start up and everything. It's now episode 6, and it's a very good lesson. Kamal was featured it did as well, so in the pilot episode, so check it out. Check it out, and if you want to volunteer, please volunteer for my webcam. I need video editors because I need more time to do video stuff. Okay, that's all.